Hey, it's Tom Lohrmann here with Doug from Coward Guitars and Paul from Paul Rhoney Guitars. We're here on Sunday, NAMM 2014. We are in the basement this year, so it's a little bit quieter, a little bit less foot traffic, but you guys have said that you like being in the basement this year, correct?
Yeah, a lot more. It's, you know, nice to not have to scream at people all dang day.
I guess without further ado, let's just get right into it. So tell us about some of the new models that you're working on for 2014 and some of the stuff that you've done for 2013.
So last year we brought out the Starliners. These were the only new thing we brought out last year. This year I went kind of crazy, so we brought a junior version out, semi-hollow version out, then I brought a flat top, basically version of our Argonaut out to make a little bit more affordable version of the Argonaut. And then I spent 2 years designing this Acadian. Basically from the minute I designed this, I knew this was what I wanted to do next, and it's basically my attempt to build the best thin line jazz guitar I could come up with. I mean, you can play it for anything, but I wanted the guitar to have the most clarity and response humanly possible. So we ended up doing like 26 1/4 inch scale, graphite reinforced neck, 2-tech bridge, this really custom ported semi-hollow interior that I designed, and a bunch of features like that, and it nails it. And then I realized if this was going to be that clear and articulate, why not build a solid body version? And market it as a drop tuning guitar, especially with a longer scale. And then I got bored and I thought, well, I should make a 7-string out of it. And I thought, well, that's not cool enough. I'll make a multi-scale 7-string. And this is the first one of those. So that's where we ended up there.
So let's jump over to Paul. Paul, this is your first year as a distributor at NAMM, correct?
Yeah, it's my first year at NAMM at all, let alone showing anything. So, you know, Wednesday when the show opened, I was nervous and just completely flustered, but I think I've gotten the hang of it and getting in the swing of things, and now it's almost over, and I'm like, where'd the time go?
So what can you tell us about these new models that you have for 2014?
So brand new stuff for this year is I've got my Oceana Duotone model. Is now coming with these Roadhouse Pickups Supro style single coils. So these are wound exactly like those old airline fiberglass body guitar pickups. So it's the single coil that looks like a humbucker. The internal construction is exactly the same down to the color of the wire. With the Mastery Bridge and the brand new Mastery Vibrato, it's a super stable, complete re-engineering of the old Jazzmaster style vibrato without all the problems. Really great stable tuning on that. So that's kind of the new thing with the Oceana Duotone. Other stuff you can see here is like this custom 3 pickup Oceana. This was just ordered this way. One of my great customers just said, hey, I want it with a cool top and I want 3 pickups. Okay, sounds good. So I do that kind of stuff all the time. This has got a kind of a cool finish on it with the copper binding, and I'm getting into weird colors of metallics and plastics and things like that. And so I thought I'd do something with a fancy finish on that. I'm getting into extended range guitars. So this is my first 7-string guitar. And this is going to be a new thing for the year. This is my Paramore model, a 7-string version of that. My 7-string version comes in 3 different scale lengths, and I'm starting on an 8-string version right after NAMM.
What would you guys, I'll ask you individually, what would you say has been the best experience that you've had at NAMM so far?
Probably sleeping at night, actually, is my favorite. No, we've had a really good time. We had great artists come by Thursday, especially. Matt Schofield, Josh Smith was here. Our friend Dane Olson was here, who's an unbelievable guitar player. And it's always, I think probably, honestly, even when we weren't exhibiting, we'd always just come down to NAMM because we like seeing our friends so much. And that's the part we always look forward to the most.
Definitely. What about you, Paul?
I've got a big long list. I mean, the show in general is an overwhelming experience, and there's a whole lot to see, and that's been really cool. I met a lot of people that I only knew online or through friends of friends, and a lot of cool builders and just other cool folks. Made a ton of friends. Just having people come and play a guitar and tell me that I did good fret work or that they like the pickups I use or something like that, it's really great.
Definitely. And where can potential clients or customers find you online?
PaulRhoneyGuitars.com, and you know, we're on Facebook, we're on Twitter, we're on Tumblr, we're on Instagram, and you can head to those places and check us out.
Awesome. What about you, Doug?
Same boat, CowerGuitars.com, K-A-U-E-R Guitars. Pretty unoriginal. So Facebook, we do, you know, like everybody else, we do a lot on there. Actually, I've been doing the most on Instagram for probably the last year and a half, and yeah. I can't believe the only people we've had come and go, I follow you on Instagram. I'm like, yes.
Well, thank you guys so much for doing the interview with me. I hope you guys have learned a little bit about these two guitar companies. Check them out on the web. And signing off now from NAMM 2014. Take care.